At the core, it seeks to repeal sections of the old law to ring fence on the Uganda Oil Company Limited, UNOC, as the sole supplier of imported petroleum products in the country.
Right Honourable Speaker, in accordance with Section 76 of the Public Finance Management Act of 2015 and our rules, Rule 118, of the Rules of Procedure of Parliament, I beg to lay on table the Certificate of Financial Implication to this Petroleum Supply Amendment Bill of 2023.
The products in question include premium motor gasoline or super petrol, automotive gas oil or diesel, Jet A1 and dual purpose kerosene. All licensed oil marketing companies shall by law be required to source their products from state-owned UNOC, save for exceptional circumstances where the entity fails to meet supplies in a given month or runs broke. Uganda, which imports 90% of its oil needs through Mombasa Port, has been reliant on the open tender system. Addressing the press after tabling the bill, Nankabira pointed out that the entrance of the state is in this highly lucrative sector is driven by necessity.
Two things which are critical, the prices, but also the security of supply. Sometimes there are tendencies of hoarding onto the products. So with UNOC being our eye into the business, I think we will even do away with hoarding.
A Government Assurances Committee report that was presented in Parliament last month indicated that between December 2021 to July 2022 alone, the average price of petrol increased by 1,810 shillings from 4,780 shillings to 6,590 shillings. A litre of diesel, on the other hand, rose by 2,200 shillings from 4,190 shillings. By the end of February 2023, statistics indicate that a litre of diesel was costing 5,280 shillings, while that of petrol was going for 5,099 shillings.
Products. Do you remember what happened on that 7th of April this year when Kenya decided to make their own marketing companies a priority and our own marketing companies here ran short of fuel? Do you know what that cost us? The prices go up, and when they go up, it is very, very difficult to see them come down. Any slightest thing that can happen in the system can end up making the products very expensive, and bringing down those costs is not easy.
Nankabira says that the amendments are aimed at improving the petroleum product stockholding levels within the country to contribute to the competitiveness of consumer and retail pump prices.
The factors that have been impacting on the fuel prices that are rotating around the Kenyan system is what I'm trying to come out of. Okay? The international prices, I have not said. But the multi-layered system of Kenya, which end up making the cost of the fuel at the pump price high, is what I'm trying to work out with.
Amid this, it is understood that UNOC with Vitol, Bahrain, EC have already sealed a five-year deal that will see the latter provide a working capital facility.
You do indeed for a
report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.
I shouldn't, but, huh?